This is the story of Jehanra, Bilkis, Nargis, Minara, Majeda, and Shonda, and the difference small loans make to their lives and their families.
Before the loan, we are in trouble. Now we are making progress.
We don't need anyone for money. We are doing well with the loan.
My husband comes in the afternoon and gives me 25 taka, and in the evening, he gives me money for the family.
Everyone dreams about doing lots of things to help their children.
People are much more conscious now, and so they are healthier.
When there is money in the hand, they feel good. Men and women, they feel happiness inside them. If there is no money, there is no pleasure.
Jehanra and her neighbors live in Shilmundir in southeastern Bangladesh, very nearly the poorest and certainly the most densely populated country on earth. Living in a vast delta, the villagers of Shilmundir suffer periodic floods and cyclones. They live always on the edge of poverty, but sometimes that's hard to see. One idea now gives them hope, health, and a degree of happiness. But does microcredit, small loans for millions of rural poor, really work?
A woman came from Dhaka, and then I contacted her, and then she said we'll start a cooperative organization. If you help me, it'll work. I contacted her again, and we set up with 25 women from this village. We called in the women from the Muslim houses as well, and then with these 25 women, we set up a BRAC microcredit scheme. And gradually, people came and took loans, and the women's lives got better.
People living in villages need access to money like anybody else. But banks in Bangladesh don't lend to the vast numbers of rural poor. BRAC, however, does. The Bangladesh Rural Advancement Committee was set up to fight the appalling poverty of the early 70s. It's now the largest lender of microcredit loans in the world, funded in part by Western aid agencies. 3 million village poor, virtually all women, take out up to $300 a year. Microcredit administration happens locally at weekly village meetings.
First of all, we ring the bell. When they hear this bell ringing, they all come to this meeting place. 35 people usually come if anyone is missing because of any problem. We have to send someone to find out what's happening to that person and then bring them here. Then we divide into groups and we sit in groups of 5 women. And then the sister collects the money from each group. And then after collecting the money, we read the 18 promises.
We'll raise our sons and daughters equally.
We'll raise our sons and daughters equally.
This week, Minara proposes that Majeda should be able to borrow 10,000 taka, about $200. Jehanra, as president of the village organization, and the cashier, Mafia, both sign. So does Bilkis, a seconder. And Majeda herself. All her peers are responsible for the loan's repayment. Two days later, Majeda sets off to collect her loan. She'll use it to grow green vegetables, to sell in local shops. The BRAC office is about 2 kilometers away.